Assalamu alaikum everybody and Ramzan Mubarak. Today I'd like to share some tips with you on how to be a bit more eco-friendly and have a greener Ramadan this year. So first of all of us want to do some prep and get some food ready and frozen beforehand. So what you can do to freeze your food is reuse containers that you already have at home, or for example when you've bought things like ice cream and butter and you have all those empty tubs, wash them and reuse them to store and freeze your food. Now if you can't do that because of space, for example, then I would suggest to use things like a paper bag. So for your kebab and samosa and all of this, then why not use a paper bag and freeze them directly? Because once you've done with them, you can put them straight into paper recycling. The other option is if really you can't use any of those containers or a paper bag, or if you have food bags, then go for food bags that are a bit thicker, that are resealable, reusable, so you can wash them again and again and reuse them. Try and avoid these thin and flimsy food bags. I know they're really cheap, but you know, you can use them once or twice tops, and then they're going to end up in the bin polluting the environment. Now unfortunately, this month of Ramadan we won't be able to have iftar together, and we won't want to you know, send food to family and friends, or maybe have a couple of people home under the 6 people rule. So the things to avoid to put any food is these plastic plates and plastic cutlery. Plastic cutlery takes at least 50 years to degrade in the environment, if not more. So plastic plates, plastic cutlery is a big no-no. Also, you have to be careful about these kind of plates that have like a gloss on it, that are a bit shiny. When you buy them, it says paper plates on them, but unfortunately they can't be recycled, because to make them look nice and shiny, there's a thin film of plastic on top of them. So these can't be recycled, so these are to avoid as well. Whether it's to send food or for parties, then avoid those. Instead, the best option for disposable would be to use these you know, cardboard thicker plates, that many of them nowadays are even compostable, and wooden cutlery if you need to really use disposable. But obviously if you can use your own dishes at home, it's even better. Now if you want to use one of these plates to send food to someone, cover them with a piece of foil. Don't use cling film. Cling film is a big no-no when it comes to plastic pollution, because you use it once and it ends up in the bin and it's going to pollute again for years to come, and it will break in microplastic that can be ingested by animals. So better to cover with foil, because foil can be recycled. Once you're done with your piece of foil, you reused it a few times, make sure it's clean, scrunch it up in a bowl, and it can go in recycling with its cans and tins at home. But make sure the bowl has to be at least the size of a tennis ball, because if it's too small, it can't get recycled. So you could, for example, scrunch up one piece of paper, leave it on the side, and as you get more foil, add it on top and make the bowl bigger and bigger before you put it in recycling. Now, if you're going to use containers to send food, for example, now, if possible, use you not reuse your own containers, plastic ones or glass or whatever you have, and ask family and friends to just return them to you, and make sure you tell them they don't have to fill them up, otherwise they'll feel obliged. So that's the best solution, because this will get obviously washed and reused again and again. Now if this option is not convenient for you, then go for foil containers that have a foil lid, because as I said previously, foil can be recycled again and again. Now, some foil containers come with these lids that seem to be, you know, paper or cardboard, but again, you have to be careful, because you can see the shine on this lid, which means that, again, it's been coated with a thin layer of plastic. So these lids cannot be recycled. Please don't put them in recycling, otherwise you're going to be contaminating the rest of your recycling. So these containers, only the foil base, once it's been rinsed or wiped, can be recycled, but not the lid. Now, other containers
you know, option. Obviously, many of us have these. So now, if you already have these plastic containers, please don't throw them away. Use them and reuse them again and again and again, and wash them. You know, they wash really greatly in the dishwasher as well, even if they're oily. But if you are going to buy something, please try and avoid this. Go for the foil instead. Also, some of us might want to use these, you know, cardboard like gift boxes. I would say if they're fully cardboard, then it's fine. But try and avoid anything that's got any plastic or any, you know, any window in there. I know it looks pretty. You can see the food inside. But is it really worth it if it's going to damage the environment? So instead, go for something that is fully cardboard so it can be reused and then recycled with paper. Now, lastly, is many of us would like to get takeaways in the month of Ramadan, which is perfectly fine. So what can we do to make our takeaways a bit more eco-friendly? So obviously we can't do anything about the containers, especially because of the virus now, but there's few tips that we can apply. So first of all, many of us get so many packs of these sauces in there. So just when you call the takeaway place you order, just give them a number or tell them I don't need sauce, because if you're gonna be eating at home, all of us will have ketchup or mayonnaise. Same with serviettes. Why do we need so many serviettes? You know, we're going to have our takeaways at home. We can all wash our hands. Same with the wipes. You know, these wipes are going to get used once, you know, and then end up in landfills, are absolutely unnecessary. Sometimes in some takeaway places, the, you know, the sauces come in those small containers. So again, only ask for as many as you need. And once you're done, just wash them and reuse them. You can, you know, store your own chili sauce, made your salad dressing, and use those instead of just, you know, throwing them away. And lastly, straws. So when we order takeaway, especially when we have, you know, milkshakes and things like that, you know, we'll be given those plastic straws that are, you know, really, really harmful, especially for animals. You know, many pieces of, tiny pieces of straws have ended up being stuck into animals, either they've swallowed them or getting stuck in, you know, even in their nose, and costing them, unfortunately, their lives sometimes. So, simple switch, don't get straws from your takeaway places. Instead, you can buy these once, you know, in a lifetime investment. You can buy these metal straws that goes in the dishwasher. You can get bamboo straws as well. You can get straws, metal ones that are collapsible and become, you know, pocket size, and you can put them in your purse. So there's so many options. I hope that all these tips have been useful. And remember, we can't change everything overnight. Just take one step at a time. If all of us make one little change this month of Ramadan, then it's going to make a big, big difference. Thank you for listening, and I hope these tips have been helpful.